Hello, everybody. It's Mr. Liquid Bread coming at you again with another beer review. Tonight, we're going to have a little junction back into Michigan again. This is a brewery out of Bay City, Michigan. Bay City, Michigan is basically right up here in the Thumb area. This is considered the Tri-City area. This Bay City, Midland, and Saginaw are all kind of intertwined in that area up there, and they call it the Tri-Cities here in the state of Michigan. This is a brewery called the Tri-City Brewing Company out of Bay City, Michigan. And I think I've had a beer from them before, a couple beers from them before, but it's been some time since I've had that. So tonight we're going to have, and this label might be a little hard to read on this shitty-ass webcam, but this is a beer called Hell's Half Mile. It's a German-style Hell's, H-E-L-L-E-S, lager. And there's the label right there if you want to take a peek at it. Hell's Half Mile, German-style Hell's lager. And again, if you see up there at the top, it's Tri-City Brewing Company. The label, basically, if you notice there, is a really, it's an old picture from, I'd probably guess that's probably a main strip there in Bay City, Michigan, back in the day, in the horse-drawn carriage days. That's what those are right there. Here's what they've got on the side here. Our Munich-style Hell's Lager is a pale golden color and pours with a creamy white head, an appealing grainy aroma with a slightly sweet malty flavor provides a full-bodied beer that is clean and refreshing. Right off the bat, I want to point out that the bottle cap, yeah, it's one of the favorite ones, one of my favorite ones, Mr. Old Golden Piece of Crap. Why in the hell companies do this? This doesn't look like a very big brewery, so that may be why they didn't put any money into the bottle caps, but to me, no excuse. Come on. I am giving a negative 1 point off for that right off the bat because it doesn't have the correct, the good eye-catching bottle cap. So let's pop this baby open. Oh, I'm having some trouble getting it open. It's got some small, the edge on the bottle cap is actually pretty small. And I just, this is a first on Mr. Liquid Bread. I just broke my bottle opener. Look at that. This bottle is a bitch. I don't know if I can get this, I can't get this open. Let's see if I can knock it off on the table. No. That's a no-go. This is what happens after you've had 4 beer reviews in one night. I got it off. That was a pain in the ass. I had to use the old beer fridge right there. Yeah, use the edge of it. So anyways, here we go. Give a little smell here. Nothing of note. Typical lager type smell, nothing to write home about. It's definitely not it's a lager obviously, but it's definitely not a domestic style lager tasting. It's got a little bit of meat to it, if you will. Definitely not a bad beer. It's good. It'd be a good summer beer if you like some. Want to switch it up? You want to get off the wheat bandwagon and hit some lager. Taste some lager beers. This is not a bad little beer out of Tri-City Brewing Company. It's got a good head in there. Speaking of which, it's pretty light in color. There's no sediment in the bottom at all. So it doesn't look like it's, looks like it's probably filtered out pretty good before it's bottled. Nope. but I, like I said, I want to build on that description on the side, and it does taste like it's got a slight Munich taste to it, or a German style. It's got more of that German type tasting. You know, it tastes like a heavily hopped lager is what it tastes like. You know, typical lagers, Budweiser, Miller Lite, Coors, the domestic lagers. You take those and you build off of those, and at this point it tastes like one of those beers, but it's got, when I say it's got more meat, it's got a little bit more hops to it, a little bit more substance, full-bodied, a full-bodied lager with slightly hoppy after notes on the tongue after you've tasted a little bit. So Hell's Half Mile, I wonder where they got that name. There is a Hell, Michigan. I don't think it's up in that neck of the woods, though, where Bay City is at, though. I wonder if that's where they got the name or something. But Hell's Half Mile, I wonder where the creativity was spun off that one. Somebody had a bad string of luck and decided to brew some beer and name it after that, maybe. I don't know. Not a bad beer, though. I don't think there's anything I really don't like about it. It's not overwhelmingly great. Would I buy this in a bar, buy it a second time? Yeah, I might buy like a six-pack or something like that and, you know, have it on the weekend or something like that. But I wouldn't go out of my way to buy this beer. I'm not looking for Hell's Half Mile, put it that way. I'd say it's above average, so above a five. I'd give it a six. But you know what? I just thought of something. Not only was the bottle cap small, gold, but it was small as hell. And on top of that, it broke my damn, look at that, it broke my damn bottle cap opener that I got from the Red Stripe girls at the bar a couple weeks ago. Look at that thing. How do you do that to a bottle cap opener? So I'm giving that sucker That's getting a five. All because of the bottling technique. Anyways, all right, let's do the slam. We'll call it a night. Got a little beer runoff there. Oh, yeah, that's a slammable beer. That's easy. Slam that puppy right down. They made that in cans. You can shotgun that bad boy. Yeah, that's good. No alcohol content on the outside of the label here. Probably have to check the website on that. But other than that, let's give it a 5 on a bottle cap. Gold. Broke my bottle cap opener. Definitely a 5. Otherwise, I'd probably give it a 6 for, you know, just above average. Nice little lager, you know. Nice little thing. Nothing special about it. So there you go. Once again, this is the Tri-City Brewery out of Bay City, Michigan. Hell's Half Mile. German style Hell's Lager. So check it out. About a 6. Good summer beer. Nice and light. Lager's the type of light beer. So have a good night, and we'll see you next time.